EPG Education 10.20. Hello dear learners, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor Devraj Goyal from the CIET NCERT New Delhi. Today we will focus on teacher education on health in India. It is under the course Perspectives, Issues and Research in Teacher Education. Let us enunciate the objectives. After going through this module, the learners will be able to produce a scenario of status of health in India, share the health hazards of the present decade, identify the mental health disorders, causes and remediation, define Human Development Index and share the HDI scenario of India, share the health concerns of India. Status of health in India. Healthy nations require healthy human beings and healthy environment. Fully healthy human beings in the 21st century are a figment of imagination. There are evident physical and mental disorders. There is degeneration of environment. The ultra-modern society has invited many imbalances. There is an alarming number of underweight children in India. Fast food is resulting into unimaginable diseases. Sparrows and honeybees are disappearing. Forests of multi-story buildings are in the perceptible range. Rivers are polluted, water is polluted, air is polluted, soil is polluted. The health issues are countless. Starting from prenatal health across the country, very few women are healthy during the pregnancy period, physically and mentally. It affects the offspring adversely. The status of soil in which the seeds are sown, the irrigation water, the fertilizers, the atmospheric air, all have degenerated. The foodstuff available in the market is largely contaminated. The green-washed vegetables and fruits are readily available in any season in the markets. There is spurt in pesticide-laced vegetables across India. The Times of India, Ahmedabad, Baroda, October 5, 2015. It is well known that vegetables sold in major cities contain pesticides, but it has now emerged that these harmful chemicals are present in alarming high doses in greens across the country. The maximum number of failed samples in most test centers was from the vegetable family. For example, a large part of vegetables available in Delhi is grown along the Yamuna and nearby regions. The data showed in Gurgaon, of the 24 samples, 11 were vegetables. In Mumbai, out of 38 samples with high pesticide content, 25 were vegetables, and in Port Blair, all 8 failed samples were from the category. In Hyderabad, 27 of 51 such samples were vegetables, and in Jaipur, it was 7 out of 10 samples. Recently, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India proposed regulations for heavy metal content in a range of food items. The drastic change in eating habits, especially of the teen age and youth, is another alarming issue. The most liked food of the present generation is constituted of pizzas, pastas, burgers, frankie, hot dogs, artificial Chinese food, and foreign food. The use of fibers in the preparation of packed fast food causes a lot of digestive problems. We have largely forgotten the Indian cultural heritage. Our tastes have changed as per the taste of the producers. A sizable number of Indians are vitamin D and B12 deficient. Most of the cold drinks are highly opaque. We do not know what we are drinking. There is overdose of preservatives. Many people have psychoneurosis, obsessive neurosis, insomnia, depression, hypertension, aggression, stress and strain, artery blockage, diabetes and tuberculosis. There is alarming fall in the heart and brain entrainment ratio. The lifestyles have changed. The digital age is suffering from many health hazards. The loss of eye power at an early age is more due to the use of electronic gadgets than any other cause. The modern kitchens seem to be beautiful in face, but create many health problems. The use of microwaves, non-sticky cookwares, and electronic appliances rather than necessity has become a fashion and prestige symbol. Overuse of microwaves results in removal of nutritive ingredients of the food. Now, top 10 health concerns of the decade. In the last 10 years, innumerable diseases and conditions have plagued mankind. From the recent swine flu pandemic to cancer, AIDS, and obesity of children, we bring you a roundup of the most alarming ones which have managed to create ripples of tension in the minds of young and old alike. Aradhana V. Bhatnagar, Jan 7, 2010, 12 a.m. IST. After sharing and discussing with several professionals and housewives across the country, we confirmed these health concerns with experts in the line of medicine and health. Here are top of the mind health concerns voiced by men, women, and also children. Heart diseases. Heart disease is the number one killer of both men and women. Now, researchers say India, a country with more than 1 billion people, will likely account for 60% of heart disease patients worldwide. A study among Asian Indian men showed that half of all heart attacks in this population occur under the age of 50 years and 25% under the age of 40. According to the Indian organization, Medwin Heart Foundation, although more than men die of heart disease than women, females tend to be underdiagnosed, often to the point that it is too late to help them once the condition is discovered. Cancer. The good news is that survival rates have improved for many types of cancer in recent years, but you can lower your risk by adopting a healthy lifestyle. Screenings also can help find some cancers early when they are most treatable. Skin, lung, prostate, colon, and testicular cancers are the ones that worry most men, while women feel anxious about breast cancer. It is second to lung cancer as the leading cause of death for women. Experts say the fear of breast cancer can sometimes be exaggerated, stopping women from going to the doctors for screening or pushing women to make rash decisions about mastectomy when it may not be necessary. HIV/AIDS, the HIV/AIDS epidemic will affect women's health in coming years. Rates of infection are found in population groups with certain high-risk behavior, that is, sex workers, intravenous drug users, and sexually transmitted disease patients. However, infection also is increasing in the general population. Despite the alarming growth of the epidemic, most women in India have very little knowledge of AIDS. Even among those who had heard of the disease, there were many misconceptions about modes of transmission. Swine flu. Soon after the outbreak of H1N1 virus in the United States and Mexico, in March 2009, the government of India started screening people coming from the affected countries at airports for swine flu symptoms. Till date, there have been 852 confirmed H1N1 deaths in the country, confirms the health ministry. What begins with sudden chills, cough, sore throat, headache, and fatigue worsen and lead to death if not detected on time. Then, reproductive health. Many of the health problems of Indian women are related to or exacerbated by high level of fertility. Research has shown that numerous pregnancies and closely spaced births erode a mother's nutritional status, which can negatively affect the pregnancy outcome. Unwanted pregnancies terminated by unsafe abortions also have negative consequences for women's health. Then, osteoporosis. a large preventable disease, the behaviors that women develop in their childhood, in their adolescence, and in their early adult years really play a significant role in the development of osteoporosis. That is because bodies build up most of bone mass until age 30. Then new bone stops forming and the focus is on maintenance of old bone. It is never too late to keep bones strong and avoid fractures. Depression. Depression appears to affect more women than men. Research has proved that women need a connection with others in their lives. They need that sustenance, and if they don't have it, they tend to get depressed. Unintentional injuries. Accidents, also called unintentional injuries, are the third leading cause of death around the world. They account for one of every four people treated in an emergency department. Death can result from motor vehicle accidents, falls, and fires. Diabetes. More than 9 out of 10 people with diabetes have type 2 diabetes. Many men don't even know they have it until they develop problems such as erectile dysfunction, vision loss, or kidney disease. Then obesity. A difficult condition to treat, obesity and overweight rates for children and teens have been steadily rising. Children who are obese face serious health problems, including asthma, joint pain, high BP, and type 2 diabetes. In the poll, parents reported that they discuss at length limiting junk food and physical activity. However, most do not curtail TV time. Then, many health disorders. Mental health disorders. 1. Oppositional Defiant Disorder, ODD, is defined by the DSM-5 as a pattern of angry, irritable mood, argumentative, defiant behavior, or vindictiveness lasting at least 6 months. Unlike children with conduct disorder, CD, children with oppositional defiant disorder, that is ODD, are not aggressive towards people or animals, do not destroy property, and do not show a pattern of theft or deceit. Sign and symptoms. The fourth revision of the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, DSM-4-TR, now replaced by DSM-5, stated that the child must exhibit 4 out of the 8 signs and symptoms to meet the diagnostic threshold for ODD. Furthermore, they must be perpetuated for longer than 6 months and must be considered beyond normal child behavior to fit the diagnosis. Signs and symptoms were actively refuses to comply with majority's requests or consensus-supported rules, performs actions deliberately to annoy others, is angry and resentful of others, argues often, blames others for their own mistakes, frequently loses temper, is spiteful or seeks revenge, and is touchy or easily annoyed. These patterns of behaviors result in impairment at school and or other social venues. Attention Deficit Hyperactive Disorder, ADHD. Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder is a brain disorder marked by an ongoing pattern of inattention and or hyperactivity, impulsivity that interferes with functioning or development. Signs and symptoms. Inattention and hyperactivity, impulsivity are the key behaviors of ADHD. Some people with ADHD only have problems with one of the behaviors, while others have both inattention and hyperactivity, impulsivity. Most children have the combined type of ADHD. In preschool, the most common ADHD symptom is hyperactivity. it is normal to have some inattention, unfocused motor activity and impulsivity. But for people with ADHD, these behaviors are more severe, occur more often, interfere with or reduce the quality of how they function socially at school or in a job, treatment and therapies. While there is no cure for ADHD, currently available treatments can help reduce symptoms and improve functioning. Treatments include medication, psychotherapy, education or training, or a combination of treatments. The most common type of medication used for treating ADHD is called a stimulant. Although it may seem unusual to treat ADHD with a medication that is considered a stimulant, it works because it increases the brain chemicals dopamine and norepinephrine, which play essential roles in thinking and attention. Then psychotherapy. Adding psychotherapy to treat ADHD can help patients and their families to better cope up with everyday problems. Parents, teachers, and family members also can give positive or negative feedback for certain behaviors and help establish clear rules, core lists, and other structured routines to help a person control his or her behavior. Therapists may also teach children social skills such as how to wait their turn, share toys, ask for help, or respond to teasing. Learning to read facial expressions and the tone of voice in others and how to respond appropriately can also be part of social skill training. Cognitive behavioral therapy can also teach a person mindfulness techniques or meditation. A person learns how to be aware and accepting of one's own thoughts and feelings to improve focus and concentration. It also encourages the person with ADHD to adjust to the life changes that come with treatments, such as thinking before acting or resisting the urge to take unnecessary risks. Now we go on to the bipolar disorders. It is a mental condition marked by alternate period of elation and depression. Bipolar disorder, or also called manic depressive, is a mental illness that brings severely high and low moods and changes in sleep, thinking, energy and behavior. People who have bipolar disorder can have periods in which they feel overly happy and energized, and other periods of feeling very sad, hopeless and sluggish. In between those periods, they usually feel normal. You can think of the highs and the lows as two poles of mood, which is why it is called bipolar disorder. About half of people during mania can also have delusions, believing things that are not true and that they cannot be talked out of, or hallucination, seeing or hearing things that are not there. Hypomania describes milder symptoms of mania in which someone does not have delusion or hallucination and their high symptoms do not interfere with their everyday life. The word depressive describes the times when the person feels very sad or depressed. Those symptoms are the same as those described in major depressive disorder or clinical depression, a condition in which someone never has manic or hypomanic episodes. Most people with bipolar disorder spend more time with depressive symptoms than manic or hypomanic symptoms. Symptoms of bipolar disorder. In bipolar disorder, the dramatic episodes of high and low moods do not follow a set pattern. Someone may feel the same mood state, depressed or manic, several times before switching on to the opposite mood. These episodes can happen over a period of weeks, months, and sometimes even years. How severe it gets differs from person to person and can also change over time, becoming more or less severe. Symptoms of mania, the highs. During depressive period, the lows, a person with bipolar disorder may have then depression. Depression is an extremely complex disease. No one knows exactly what causes it, but it can occur for a variety of reasons. Some people experience depression during a serious medical illness. Others may have depression with life changes such as a move or the death of a loved one. Still others have a family history of depression. Those who do may experience depression and feel overwhelmed with sadness and loneliness for no known reason. What are the main causes of depression? There are a number of factors that may increase the chance of depression, including the following. Now, obsessive-compulsive disorders. It is believed that obsessive-compulsive disorder is likely to be the result of a combination of either neurobiological genetic behavior, cognitive, or environmental factors that trigger the disorder in a specific individual at a particular point in time. Serotonin, abnormalities or an imbalance in the neurotransmitter or brain chemical serotonin could also be to blame. Serotonin is the chemical in the brain that sends messages between brain cells, and it is thought to be involved in regulating everything from anxiety to memory to sleep. Medications known as selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, SSRIs, are often used to treat OCD, although it is not fully known why the SSRI medications seem to help some people with OCD. Schizophrenia and hallucination. Individuals with schizophrenia often experience hallucinations. Hallucinations are perceptual experiences which occur without any actual source. In other words, there is no actual stimulus in the environment creating the sound, image, etc. The schizophrenic perceives something as very real, even though it is not real at all. Hallucinations can involve any one of the senses: sight, sound, taste, smell, or touch. The most common hallucinations experienced by schizophrenics, however, are auditory in nature. Auditory hallucinations. Auditory hallucinations usually involve voices talking to or about the person. Most of the time, the voices either provide a running commentary on whatever the schizophrenic individual is doing, or they tell the person that he she should do. They may also be carrying on conversations or give warnings alerting the schizophrenic about potential danger or harm. The imaginary voices heard by schizophrenic individuals are disturbing. Voices which tell them what to do are referred to as command hallucinations. These can be especially problematic if they are telling them to harm themselves or something else. Visual hallucination. Schizophrenics can also have visual hallucinations, which are the second most common type with this disorder. Visual hallucinations involve seeing things which are not really there. They may involve images which are very clear as well as vague or distorted. Visual hallucinations can be especially frightening depending on the image. Olfactory hallucinations involve the sense of smell. They often involve an unpleasant smell, and sometimes the schizophrenic person believes, much to his or her embarrassment, that the odor is coming from his or her own body. Then tactile hallucinations involve the sense of touch and may, for example, involve the feeling that snakes or bugs are crawling on or inside the body. Also, the person may believe an invisible hand or fingers are touching him, her. Then, gustatory hallucinations involve the sense of taste. This may be experienced as a strange taste in something they are eating or drinking. Treatment. Hallucinations are most effectively treated with antipsychotic medications. For some individuals, antipsychotic may completely eradicate the hallucinations. For others, they may only reduce them to some degree. The reverse of the proverb, health is wealth, wealth is health, seems to be the major contributor towards all kinds of health issues. For revival of health, we should go back to our old politeness and ancient culture, namely simple living and high thinking, with naturalism, naturopathy and full yoga. The present module further focuses on Human Development Index, Universe Development Index, Heart and Brain Entrainment Ratio, problems of beta thalamajor and dementia in India. Human Development Index. The Human Development Index is a composite statistic of life expectancy, education, and income indices. Published on 4th November 2010 and updated on 10th June 2011, starting with the 2011 Human Development Report, the HDI combines three dimensions: a long and healthy life, life expectancy at birth, education index, mean years of schooling and expected years of schooling, and a decent standard of living, GNI per capita. In its 2010 Human Development Report, the UNDP began using a new method of calculating the HDI. The following three indices are used: life expectancy index, LE minus 20 divided by 82.3 minus 20. Education index, under root of MYSI minus EYSI whole divided by 0.951. Mean year of schooling index, that is MYSI, is equal to MYS divided by 13.2. Then expected years of schooling index, EYSI, is equal to EYS divided by 20.6. Income index, income GNIPC minus income 100 divided by income 107721 minus income 100. Finally, the HDI is the geometric mean of the previous three normalized indices. HDI is equal to geometric mean of life expectancy index into educational index into income index. Life expectancy. Life expectancy at birth, MYS, that is mean years of schooling, years that a 25-year-old person or older has spent in schools. EYS, expected years of schooling, years that a 5-year-old child will spend with his education in the whole life. GNIPC, gross national income at purchasing power parity per capita. GNIPC, gross national income at purchasing power parity per capita. From HDI to UDI. When will we move from HDI to UDI? That is from Human Development Index to Universe Development Index. It is because rather than nurturing the nature, we have started abusing the nature. Rather than treating the nature as source, we have started using her as resource. Trees are being cut brutally. Animals are being killed inhumanly. Even when we can satisfy our hunger with vegetarian food, we have the courage to go for non-vegetarian. We are becoming smarts, smart cities and smart villages. There is a need to redefine smart in India. The worst states of our roads speak a lot of our psyche and soul. Every entity has its own place in the universe. Every element of this universe needs to be duly respected. Where have gone the sparrows, butterflies, and glowworms? What is the rate of plantation of microwave towers? Is Digital India the resolve to all the problems of India? Which are the considerations for new system designs and conversion? A sparrow is as significant as a human baby. A tree is as important as a human being. A glowworm is as important as a saint. Tiger, deer, and elephants are as important as human creatures. A neem is as important as a multi-story building. The nests of the birds are as important as the multi-bedrooms. Children carry their own bottles. We, the human beings, have made our lives miserable. Most of the problems are deliberately invited by the so-called civilized modern human beings. What is the result? Let us not be oversmart. There is a need to develop universe development index, considering life expectancy of every organism, healthy culture of every organism, and investment and income on every entity. Then holistic health. A person is said to be healthy when the body embodies all the subsystems at the proper place, structurally and functionally, and there is optimum interrelation, interdependence among them, and all of these constitute a unit integrated whole, swasth. Swasth means when all the organs are there at their own place, properly interrelated, properly interdependent, which works efficiently, effectively, and easily. This is the state where ideas spring, feelings flow, motor creates, the soul reigns, and the self resonates with all naturally. There is equation amongst darshan, that is ideas, achar, that is behavior, and karma, the action. There is heart and brain entrainment. There is optimum secretion and equation of adrenaline and dopamine. Now, beta thal major problem in India. Problems of dementia in India. Problems of dementia is on the increase in India. A large number of we Indians are suffering from compulsive, recursive, obsessive neurosis, which causes anxiety, tension, stress, strain, inattention, headache, forgetfulness, and diffidence. It is self-killing. There is an immediate need of thinking training in India. Some concerns. I think all of us need to look into our food habits. Then environment pollution, we ought to healthy environment. Lifestyles, we have to healthy lifestyles. And we need to learn how to integrate technology. We ought to have added focus on medical practices. The mall culture is on the increase. We have to see that which rate the mall culture should be there in India and how to have proper mall culture rather than having mall crowds. We ought to focus on preventive measures as well as ameliorative measure, because diagnosis of a case is as important as prognosis for its disposition. Health education is a big issue in my country, in India. I think all of us need to be very sensitive to that we observe sound health. And we need to be very sensitive to the human development index in our country, because as presented earlier, that human development index is a geometric mean of education expectancy, life expectancy, and per capita income. Now let us try to conclude. Degenerating health of all of us in India is an alarming issue. It needs to be attended to on priority basis. There is a need to employ all the possible medical sciences such as naturopathy, homeopathy, allopathy, and Ayurveda. Thank you.